Yep, go ahead.
Thank you.
sisters, would you please rise? Marlene Myrna Haslam Fellows. She was born July 2nd, 1941 in Logan, Utah. She passed away on November 22nd, 2020 in Preston, Idaho. Today, the funeral services are being held at Webb Funeral Home on Monday, November 30th, 2020 at 2 p.m. I'm Jeff Gill, I'm the bishop, and I will be conducting the services. The pallbearers are as follows. David Fellows and Ron Fellows are sons. And Sue Pollard, Pollard. Sorry. And I tried doing it. I did it right the first time. Pollard. A son-in-law and Carol Fellows Kirkpatrick. And that's the pallbearers. And did I miss Ryan Fellows, Tyler Rouse, or grandson? Honorary pallbearers are Kim Fellows, a son. The grandchildren are Brandon Fellows, Chantel Fellows, Crosley, Heather Fellows, Louie, her last name is Louie, and Serena Fellows Cook, Anna Lee Fellows, Tiana Fellows, Carly Fellows, and Ben Pearson, Bradley Fellows, Haley Fellows, Amanda Rouse, Ian Kirkpatrick and Grace Kirkpatrick. I apologize if I butchered your name there. Sorry about that. We will have the family prayer, which is given by Kayleen Fellows, a daughter-in-law. The prelude and postlude music is being offered by Diana Jones, a ward member. A congregational hymn will be hymn 86, How Great Thou Art. Diana Jones may the accompany us, and Julie Lefevre will be our chorister. Our invocation will be by David Fellows, a son. The life sketch will be by Teresa Fellows, a daughter-in-law. Then we will sing a congregational hymn, I Need Thee Every Hour. That hymn is on page 98. Then there will be some remarks by Susan Fellows, Pollard, daughter, Carol Fellows, Fitzpatrick, a daughter, Amanda Rouse and Haley Fellows, a granddaughter. And we'll go to that point, brothers and sisters.
Thank you. Services for our mother, grandma, sister, brother, friends at the funeral of Marlene Myrna Haslam Fellows. At this time, we're grateful for knowledge of the plan of salvation, knowledge that she is in a better place. She's with her husband and our dear grandfather and father. This time we ask for thy spirit to comfort us in our time of mourning, but we do this in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. We'd like to thank you for coming today. We appreciate you taking the time to join us in the celebration of our mother's life and saying farewell for me.
Oh, we don't care. We will be with us. Our mom was born on July 2nd, 1941, in Logan, Utah, at the Cache Valley General Hospital. Her parents were Myrna Peterson Haslam and David Hutchinson Haslam. Our mother was the second of four children. She had three brothers, Lloyd, Robert, and Carl Haslam. Our mother grew up in Dayton, where she went and completed her elementary and secondary schooling and graduation from West High School in 1960. After graduating from high school, our mom worked in the Corner Café in Preston. In 1962, our mother met H. Reed Fellows, where he was on leave from the Navy service and stopped by the Corner Cafe. Reed asked her mother to go with him to a movie in Logan. 2 weeks later, on December 7, 1962, they were married. Their marriage was later solemnized in the Logan Temple. Our mother and dad went on a honeymoon to Hawaii and ended up being stationed there for 18 months. Our mother helped raise David, our oldest brother, from our dad's previous marriage. Over the years, our mom and David became close, and his family closer than they've always been, and will always be an important part of our family. Our mom and dad's first child, Tim, was born while they lived in Hawaii. Mom and dad next lived in Seattle, Washington for 18 months, while dad was stationed in an icebreaker in the North and South Pole. While dad was on the icebreaker, mom moved back to Preston to live with Grandpa and Grandma Haslam. During this time, mom and dad's second child together, Ron, was born. The next place mom and dad were stationed during dad's Navy career was Diego, California, where they lived for 18 months. Their first daughter, Suzanne, was born there. Mom and dad then moved to Charleston, Carolina, where their second daughter and last child, Carol, was born. Our mom experienced great joy in her children and was proud of our accomplishments. The last place our mom and dad lived before moving to Preston was Virginia Beach, California. They traveled the country with our dad. Mom moved to Preston in 1972 while dad continued to tour the world until he retired from the Navy in April of 1974. Family is generally what's important to our mom. She enjoyed spending time with family and extended family members at reunions and various activities. Throughout the years, mom's reunions were important to the Haslam and Peterson families. Remembered attending many reunions at both Grandpa's and Grandma Peterson's and Grandpa and Grandma Haslam's houses where we were younger. Our memories are mostly of all the kids playing games, mostly outside, and the adults sitting around the table visiting. Our mom always prepared several side dishes to share at the reunion and helped our Grandma Peterson, Grandma Haslam, and other family members preparing the meals. Although our mom spent less time with her brothers and sister-in-law in the past few years, it was important to her to attend the A.J. Peterson reunion each summer to stay connected with her family. Our mother developed loving relationships with brothers and sister-in-laws. Mom had a close relationship with her sister-in-law, Esther, Don's wife, and enjoyed spending time with her. We have great memories of visiting Don, Esther, and their family in Shelley, Idaho, and remember our mom and dad visiting with Don and Esther for many hours. Mom also enjoyed spending time with Dad's brother, Doug, and his wife, Geneva, and their family. Geneva shared with us that our mother was such a great lady when she learned of her passing. We are grateful that our mother was able to have such meaningful relationships with her brothers and sisters-in-laws. grandchildren are a bright part spot in her life. She enjoyed heaven.
Able to help take care of Amanda, Tyler, Ryan, Natalie, and Tiana, and Preston. There are many photos of the grandchildren spending time at her house, and we know it. We know it brought our mother such joy to have her there. While in Hawaii and before Tim was born, our mother worked in a pineapple plantation. Once she began having children, our mother did not work outside the home for many years, so she could focus on being a mom. Oftentimes she was a single mom because our dad was either busy with the Navy duties or he was stationed on a ship and not able to be at home. Once all of our children were a little older, mom began working as a certified nursing assistant in the Preston Nursing Home. She enjoyed working in a service-related job and caring for residents. Unfortunately, she fell and broke her femur in her mid-40s, which results in many surgeries for several successive years. After these many surgeries, our mom wanted to do something in the workforce to stay busy. Her last job was doing food samples at Sam's Club in Logan. She enjoyed meeting people and developing friendships in whatever job she was doing. Mom and Dad had many adventures together during the years. Our dad was in the Navy, as well as after moving to Preston, and then he retired. The folks who worked for this past week illustrated the many friendships they had made while stationed across the country. Raising their children and working took most of their time in their younger years. We know how much our dad loved our mother. He told us many times over the years that our mother was the best thing that ever happened to him. He loved her dearly and appreciated having her in his life. Our mother loved our dad in her quiet but devoted way. Our mom has missed our dad very much since he passed away in 2015. It brings us comfort to know that they are together again in heaven. Our mother's faith fulfilled her, and she was a devoted member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. The church was a constant in our mother's life. She never doubted her belief and faith in the doctrine. She held many positions in the church throughout her life, including visiting teaching supervisors for the Day Society. She made cherished friends through the church and enjoyed and appreciated their friendship. We want to thank the many people who our mom considered cherished friends, including Susan Anderson, Sandra Hubbard, Gail Mosman, and Lynn Johnson, and Rowe Tanner. We also want to thank the many people who helped our mom in her later years, including Andy Mosman and Leonard Ward. We also want to thank Dixie Wells, who had been our mother's best friend since their school years in Dayton. Dixie and her mother maintained their friendship, stayed connected through their lives. They would talk frequently on the phone, including our last conversation in October. She was grateful to Dixie for being such a good friend to our mom until the very end of her life. Sometimes we realize that our mom in the past week, her reflection is how simple it was to make her happy. She loved the phone calls or visiting from any of us. She appreciated having us taking the time to let us know we were thinking of her. What we won't miss about our mom is her quiet but consistent presence. She was always there for us, always available when we needed her. We won't miss how she enjoyed being with her children and her grandchildren. We're holding on to the precious memories that we have to her on her and our time together, which now will never seem like it was long enough. In closing, I want to share a prayer that was help us find peace. Heavenly Father, at this moment, nothing seems to be available to help the loss we feel about our mother's past. Our hearts are broken and our spirits mourn. All we know is that your grace is sufficient. And there is comfort knowing she is with you in heaven. We love you forever, Mom.
you sent this little person to me. If I ever had somebody I needed to talk to, I knew she was always there. I could pick up the phone and call her. And I could always count on her if I needed someone to watch my kids. Mom, I'm gonna miss you so much. I am so glad I had a chance to call you when you were in the hospital and hear your voice. For the very last time, that is one phone call I will never forget. And I'm glad that you've been there for Amanda this past year. She's been there for you, and she'll still be there. And just know that Grandma loves you, and she'll always love you. She'll always be a part of you. And Tyler as well. Grandma still will always be a part of you, and she's always watching out for you as well. Grandma's always been a part of my kids' life, and I know she always will be. I just want you to let me know, Mom, that I love you, and I will never ever forget you, and I will love you forever, and I cannot wait to ever see you again. I know we will be together again. I see this is the interest rate.
What I've been thinking of the last 2 weeks is the same hindsight as 2020. I think we've all lived that. And throughout this whole process, I've been praying each day for God's guidance and how to do the best for our mom and our family throughout the situation. And in that reflection, I realized some things about my mom and our life together that I wanted to share with you today. So my dad was the biggest part of my life, I always thought, growing up. And many of you who know me will hear me say that. What I didn't realize is how much my mom actually did influence me. And that's that hindsight 2020. She was a quiet person, but she was always there and always consistent. And now I reflect back about the qualities of my mom that I took for granted. She was a sweet and loving lady, and it was actually the CMB team who pointed that out to me one day when they were telling me how sweet my mom was. And I was like, she really is a very sweet and loving lady. And for some crazy reason, I didn't learn that until luckily the last few months of her life. And I'm grateful for that life lesson. I want to share a couple other things that I've learned as I've reflected, and I know these are brief remarks, so I promise not to take too long. But I did want to share two things that I think are very important that I've learned and want to carry with me. Perceptions and lived experiences change over time. And my perception of my mom growing up was that we didn't have very much in common. And that was really out of my naivety and my immaturity. And unfortunately, that lasted a little too long into my life. But early on in my life, it was easier for me to focus on our differences than to focus on what we had in common. And those differences were a barrier in our lives for a long time and didn't allow me to become as close as I know some of my siblings are with my mom. I didn't appreciate the qualities that I now realize were very much a part of my mom, and how I realize now influenced who I am today. Her kindness, which so many people pointed out, maybe, her service to others, and her strength and resilience. Anyone who knows my mom knows that she lived through many health challenges with quiet perseverance. And I believe the strength and resilience I have today is largely because of my mom. I wish I would have learned earlier to accept the differences that my mom and I had, and that would allow me to focus on the positive qualities, so we could have had a stronger relationship. But I am grateful for the time that I had more recently to get to know her and let her know how much I loved her. The other lesson I wanted to share is to choose priorities wisely. I think many of us have figured this out a little bit already in 2020, given the circumstances that we've all been living through. But I definitely have realized that some things are more important than others. My mom's passing has enlightened me even more on that. So time spent with your people is so precious. And the thing that you can never have is that time once they're gone. There's a lot of things that I would give up in a heartbeat right now to have more time with my mom. And I hope I remember this valuable lesson as I move forward and keep my family and my friends as a priority. And I pray that these reflections help me become a better parent and a better person as we move forward. So in closing, I want to thank the many people who have been so tremendously helpful the last several months, and especially the last few weeks. I want to thank Drs. Knapp and Jeffers and the Franklin County Medical Team, especially the nurses who cared for my mom and communicated with me every day, more than once a day, to let me know what was going on with my mom. I want to thank the people who cared for my mom in the last recent months. Before that, I want to thank Teresa for all of the time and care that you provided to our mom over the years. It's invaluable, and there's nothing that we can ever do to say thank you enough. I also want to thank Angela White, Mindy Anderson, and Nancy Hobley, who did help provide some in-home care in the last few months of my mom's life. I want to thank the Sunday Home Health and Hospice team, Kelly and Donna, who went in and provided home health services to my mom. Earlier this year, actually, with some health problems, and then more recently, when she came out. I want to thank Kelly and the rest of the hospice team and the Heritage Senior Living team who provided such kindness and care to my mom in her final days that allowed her to pass with respect and grace. I especially want to thank Tracy Kent for the many, many texts and phone conversations that we've had since August. She was an invaluable source of support, guidance, and kindness, and I will forever be grateful to you. I want to thank the many friends in the Third Ward. Teresa's already mentioned some, but in the last few weeks, there's been many who have been so helpful to step up. Jordan and Harvey Tanner, and Andy Mosman, and Jeff Gill, thank you so much for your time and the various tests that you helped with. I do want to especially thank Doreen. She texted me very frequently to ask about our mom, and she called our mom in the last few weeks of her life, the day before she died even, and just, you know how much that meant to my mom to hear Doreen's voice. I want to thank my family and friends in closing, who have sent their support and love and continue to do so. The prayers, texts, and emails have been so helpful. It does not take away the pain and the heartbreak that I will feel for probably a really long time. But the feeling of love and support from our friends and family does bring me some peace and comfort. So thank you to you all.
I was always spending some time with her, whether it was watching TV or watching movies with her, or even helping her get something from the stores. My grandma is my role model, is the role model in the world, the best role model in the world.
So I don't have too many memories, but I do know there's, they're just very deep and I can't remember the moment. But the ones I do remember is always going to the Preston Parade on Main Street and watching the parade with her, catching some candy for her, helping her build puzzles, and because she loved puzzles. The Easter egg hunts that her and Grandpa would always put on for all of us, grandkids go find. I remember picking plums on the plum tree with her once or twice. Watching TV shows and movies that she liked. And then just a little bit ago, I was remembering, like, just whenever my dad and I went up there by ourselves, and I would just hang out with both of them. And it was so fun. I do miss them both, and I will miss them both forever, but I know that I'm so happy they're together, and I feel them being together. I'm so happy, and I know they're going to watch all of us and keep us all safe. And
brothers and sisters, what a great tribute to your mother, sister, grandmother. It was a great tribute that you guys all give to her. Just a couple of things I just wanted to mention. Death. Physical death is a separation of the spirit from the mortal body. The fall of Adam brought physical death into the world. Because of the atonement and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, all mankind will be resurrected and redeemed from their physical death. Death is an essential part of Heavenly Father's plan of the salvation. In order to become like our eternal Father, we must experience death and later receive a perfect resurrected body. Because of the atonement and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, physical death is only temporary. As in Adam, all die, even if Christ shall all be made alive. Everyone will be resurrected, meaning that every person's spirit will be reunited with his body and restored in their proper and perfect frame, and no longer subject to death. Brothers and sisters, I know that we all have different beliefs, and that is my belief, what I just read, and I know that was Marlene's belief. She was a great member of our ward, and she was a great example of all of us. I appreciate the opportunity that I've had to be able to. I'm not a long-winded guy when it comes to this kind of stuff, but I do know that you guys have got a lot of memories, and I know that your grandma and your mother was very proud of all of you, and you should be proud of that. And I say those things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Now we will sing your congregational hymn on page 152, God Be With You, Till We Meet Again. Then the benediction will be by her granddaughter, Anna Lee Fellows. And then we will have the dedication of the grave by her son, Ron Fellows. And that will be at the Dayton Cemetery. And compassionate service has been offered by the Relief Society. So when we get over to the cemetery, if you will watch for me, we've got some sack lunches for each one of you to be able to take with you due to COVID. We thought about not having lunch because we didn't want to be in the room by ourselves there. So we will follow the hearse over. There won't be any police escorts or anything like that, but we will reconvene over in the cemetery in Dayton.
Till we meet again.
gracious Heavenly Father. We come to you at this time as a family to ask for your comfort and to thank you for the time that we have with Grandma. Heavenly Father, we all know that she made us a better person. And that no matter what, she is with us. Heavenly Father, thank you for your atonement and for the Holy Ghost and the comfort that He gives. Heavenly Father, please be with all of us as we go through this process, that we know that we're never alone. And we will be able to turn to people we love for the comfort. Heavenly Father, we love you very much, and we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, would you please arise?
I'd like to invite those serving as pallbearers to feel step in the front. Let's have you step just outside the door. We'll have you three on the side of the room, right? And then you'll just follow us out, okay?
See you guys. Thank you very much. Thank you.
That was good. Trust me.